The Mischief of Pride, Part 4.
Rahul Bhatt.
Jai Sachidanand Pujyashree. Pujyashree, Dada has said that when you want to keep the Jagruti, or awakened awareness, of separation, then you should make use of the four things: friendship, bribery, punishment, and division. But my experience is such that when man or pride breaks apart, then nothing works other than division. We say the words of Gnan, or we analyze, or whatever we do, but we can't seem to see the other person as faultless. And that suffering continues to remain. So today you said that this will remain no matter what you do, and you need to keep seeing it and keep it separate.
You must do penance.
Yes, we must do penance. Up until now, Rahul believed that penance means to keep seeing the suffering that arises. But today you provided more clarity that it's not that we must only see the penance, but we need to see the other person as faultless. We need to see the other person as the non-doer. A lot of clarity came from that. But will the penance decrease due to that?
There is no need to decrease the penance. When the inner garbage melts, our penance will end. The inner garbage is melting away by doing penance. And if we do this by seeing the nimit or evidentiary instrument as faultless, then we will have exactness. Otherwise, we'll feel that, oh, some of it is his fault and some of it is my fault. So real pratikaman will not occur, and the fault, penance will also not occur. If you deem others to be at fault, then penance will break. So this is the right understanding, that the other person is 100% faultless. If we hit our head on a door, then which tree in the jungle will you go and fight with? Whose kids are these? Who made this door? Which tree was this made from? Do we look for such answers? On the contrary, we will go home and try to heal the wound. So if you're seeing the door as faultless here, then similarly, if we get hurt by anyone's words, then we should see them as faultless. Oh, I got hurt, so it is my fault. It isn't the fault of the one who hurt me. But this ego is such that when, like how you asked here, when man breaks apart, why don't any of the keys work? It's because he becomes completely blind there. His man was severely wounded. And actually, what happens is that it depends on how thick his man is or how thin his man is. If it's very thick, then you have to keep it separate, because trying to fit the right understanding will be of no use there. The penance at that time is simply that, oh, this is good. This filled stock of karma is burning away. But still, the enemies within us don't even let us say that this is a good thing. A lot of suffering prevails within, but we should understand from within what we had decided beforehand. Insults are beneficial. The one insulting me is my benefactor. We should repeat 50 times that the one insulting me is my benefactor. Then the enemies within us will argue, what do you mean he's beneficial? We shouldn't let these kinds of people get away. Who does he think he is? He's ruining Dada's work, and he's leading people in the wrong direction. They would start up a great amount of turmoil from within. Yet we should carefully say, whatever you've said is incorrect. What Dada says is correct. If we want to be free, if we are suffering, then whose fault are we going to see? We should keep raising our point, keep raising our understanding of Nyan. It will take time. They will not let you speak.
Right.
Because everything will be engrossed in the suffering. But that unfolding karma is such that it eventually decreases. So it will go to its peak and then it will start to decrease. Until then, if our intellect is causing chaos, then we should understand the part of division in the four: friendship, bribery, punishment, and division. You can only keep it separate through the use of division, because we have tasted the state which is free from uneasiness and agitation.
Yes.
And the ego is hurt and suffering, so we will not be engrossed in it. We will be separate, and that suffering that is there, because what has happened is that our prajna, or direct light of the self, has become separate. Prajna will flash its light and say, it's good that this suffering came to this man, it's beneficial. The intellect will say opposing things 10 times, and it will let us say once that this is beneficial. Meaning that we will say it is beneficial, but the intellect will keep pressuring us. So it is in this period that we need to do penance. What does penance mean? It means that we have to pass this time. Oh, this is burning. The wood is burning, it's burning, it's burning, let it burn, let it burn. The intellect will keep nagging until it turns into ashes. And this will not end in one day. It may last 6 months or even 12 months. It will start burning again a few days later.
Yes.
We have to do penance there. Oh, it's the man which is burning. It's good that this is happening. So just hold on to this much.
But why does that happen? Once we cool down, we feel that, okay, now it's all good.
No.
Then again,
one layer goes away and then another layer comes up. So then the internal burning starts again. It's because the intellect has evidence supporting how the other person is at fault. I am right, I am correct, yet they wrongfully insulted me. The intellect shows all that, but will we go to moksha on the basis of man? Will we be able to go to moksha with man?
No.
So we will have to clear out the man, and nature is helping us break apart the man by giving us beatings. So we should be grateful for it. It's good this happened. I want to reduce my man to 0%. And I want to remove the man of doing good and the man of doing bad. I want to get rid of the man which helps others and the man which hurts others. I want to remove the man entirely. I don't want to side with the man. Why does man arise? Why do we get hurt from insults? It's because you and Rahul become one.
Okay.
It has entered because we remained one in the last life, and now we will remain separate, so it will clear out. It doesn't let us remain separate, because the karma that was bound is giving rise to an effect of engrossment. But since our prajna has become separate, we feel that, oh, it's happening to him, not to me. I am pure soul, I am pure soul. So if the internal turmoil occurs 1,000 times, then the nyan remains present once or twice that this is wrong, this is wrong.
Yes, right.
By repeatedly doing that, ultimately, the wood will burn away, and the self is not going to burn at all. Only agnyan, or relative knowledge, is going to burn away. Nyan will certainly not burn. So what happens over time? After 6 months or 12 months, the suffering will end and our nyan will win. But we do not want to miss this. The first thing is that we don't want to see the nimit at fault. And secondly, we need to keep telling file 1 that you are suffering, so it's your fault. So when you win over the suffering by doing penance, then the experience of bliss will arise. And after that, you will be able to clear out many other small sufferings with ease. If you defeat a big suffering, then the small sufferings will not be able to break your steadiness.
And you said that the karmic tuber of man will break only when insults come.
There's no other way.
But you also said that if you practice seeing the other person as faultless, then are there keys like that which at least help us sharpen our jagruti?
Yes, see positives in others.
Oh, okay.
Just hold on to one key of seeing the positives of others. And does the intellect let us see positives?
No, I mean,
does the intellect let us see positives in the one who insults us?
Not when someone bothers us, but otherwise it does.
Yes, so it lets you see it otherwise. But we should keep it in our awareness that, oh, weren't you saying how good of a person he is? So then consider him good right now. Then the intellect will reply, how can I consider him a good person if he hurts me? So we should say, no, if a golden blade cuts us, it's still a golden blade, right? If we sell it, then we'll get good money for it. So shouldn't we see that it's made of gold? It's currently been made into a knife, so it's able to cut things. But if it cuts us, then that's because we collided with it. That's why we got cut. Otherwise, the knife looked beautiful because it's made of gold. Similarly, he is a pure soul in the real, and the prakriti or non-self complex is like this. And it's the karmic account of our prakriti, that's why we got hurt. Therefore, it is not his fault. We should have an established principle that without causes, effects definitely cannot come. And the effect comes through nimits. Therefore, the nimits are not at fault. The effect is due to our causes. That's a very great discovery of Dadas. Then your next question is, man and moh, or illusory attachment, are both kashai.
But why is there a difference in the suffering between them? The suffering caused by insults and the effect of moha, the physical effect, is what I'm asking about. So what is happening at the subtle levels such that the feeling is different for both of them?
At the end of the day, they are both separate, right? What I mean by them being separate is that fundamentally it is moha. What kind of moha? Darshan moha, or the conviction that I am Rahul. That is the original moha. Then the moh of I have moh towards my wife is at the secondary level.
Right.
Now what is the rule? Leave the original moh aside, but that other moh that arose that says, I am a husband, I am his father, I am his father-in-law, I am his manager, I am an engineer. Now attachment and abhorrence arises out of that moh. If we say, I am a husband, and if the wife agrees with us, then our prevalence as a husband becomes stronger. But if our wife doesn't agree with us, then our prevalence as a husband gets provoked. And we think, what does she think of herself? Why isn't she listening to me? Why did I get married to you? Why are you lazy about getting work done? So he prevails as a husband there. So man is originally considered as moh, and attachment arises from moh, and then abhorrence arises from it afterwards. If the wife adjusts, then attachment will arise. And if she doesn't adjust, then abhorrence will arise. So that's attachment and abhorrence. And under abhorrence falls anger and man, and under attachment falls greed and deceit. So the original mo is the first mo, and then this is the secondary mo. We call the first mo a blunder, and we call the second mo a mistake. These pieces break off from the original mo, and then anger, pride, deceit, greed are born from that. Now man is just one part of that which is being cut, and this is the suffering that arises due to that. Whereas this mo, so the original karmic tuber of mo is certainly there, but from that, this part came out which says, I am a husband. And to prevail as a husband, there is the mo to prevail as a husband, there is the man to prevail as a husband, there is the greed to prevail as a husband, and there is the deceit to prevail as a husband. It begins to split into sub-branches. What is it originally like? There is the man to prevail as a husband. Actually, it is considered mo to prevail as a husband, but how does the form of mo get extended? Through the man of prevailing as a husband. If he cannot prevail as a husband, then he uses anger to protect it. So he protects man using anger. Then there is also mo in prevailing as a husband. He would be in a slight state of unawareness due to that mo. That is considered greed, the greed to prevail as a husband. And that's where deceit would lie. If he cannot do things the way he wills and wants using anger, then he uses deceit instead. So after becoming the husband, he does the way he wills and wants through deceit. So that is how man keeps getting extended. Now, when he suffers a beating and turns back, when the man suffers a beating, there is no deceit or greed in that. So the internal burning would be different there. There would be more internal burning.
There is no deceit or greed in man?
That subtle level of deceit and greed is there, but this is regarding the two divisions of anger, pride, and deceit, greed. If we split it up that way, then there is deceit and greed in man, but it's at a subtle level. It's not at a gross level. There is no gross deceit and greed.
Right.
So for man, there is pride for man and anger for man. And on this side, there is greed for man and deceit for man. When there is greed and deceit for man and he gets insulted, then he will be cunning and will feel, that's fine, I'll get man in another way from somewhere else. So he will have less suffering. The one that has greed and deceit in man will have less suffering. Whereas the one who has pride for man and anger for man, he will have tremendous inner burning. He will have so much suffering that he will not be able to stand it. He will feel like he is dying. That person has fewer layers, whereas the other person has gone out further by having greed and deceit for man. And if he doesn't have hunger for man in one area, then he will go get it from two or three other places. So he will place his sufferings in another place and quietly go to sleep. Whereas the one with pride and anger won't have another place to put it, so he will be very hurt.
That's a very nice subtle distinction you provided, Deepak Bhai. When you talked about royal man, all those examples fit in Rahul. So then the question is that, for Dada's work, what happens is that a nice meal was cooked, but then the waiter would take all the credit for it. That's what happens. So what kind of Jagruti do we need to keep there? Because, like you mentioned, file 1 definitely has this fixed somewhere at the subtle level. That seems clear.
The 5 levels. Progress by using the 5 levels and 4 steps.
Okay.
No one should get hurt by this man. The karmic tuber of man will not empty out today. It will not stop today. And you will not be able to stop it today. It was because of man that we were living. Isn't there a saying that goes, if there is undigested food in the body, then you feel strong. If he runs out of it, then he becomes weak and ill. Similarly, this man is a type of strength. But we want to use this strength in the right direction. Man will not stop. It will get used, then it will wear out, and then it will end. And this is the area where it will get used. So it will get used, it will wear out, and then it will continue to empty out. But have the intent that no one should get hurt by this man, and I should not suffer because of this man. We are making progress simply by holding on to these 2 levels. The 3rd level is the sweet taste of man, which we aren't considering right now. Do you understand? We are not touching the 3rd, 4th, or 5th levels right now, but the 1st level. Because when he does not get enough of this man, then he ends up hurting others. Or if he doesn't get enough man, then he ends up bickering. Or if some insults come his way, then he starts suffering. So the 1st 2 levels. What is the result of that? He starts to see others' faults, or does negative things to others. Or he shares someone's negatives with others. He may say it directly or to someone else. So first, let's win over this level in which we end up hurting others due to this man. And if you are not getting man, or if you are not getting enough man, then have the intent that I do not want to hurt others. The second part is that if we get insulted, or discredited, or defamed, or accused, then we want to see the nimit as faultless. No, this nimit is extremely beneficial for helping me break my disease of man. That is how we want to let man break apart or have it burn away. That's where we will do penance. Do you understand?
Jai Sachidanand.
Jai Sachidanand. Let's do samayik. Let's see the faults of man. We talked about a lot of things. A hungry prakriti has existed for infinite time. The prakriti is hungry for man, and if it's not able to get man directly, then it tries to attain man using anger. And if it still does not get man, then it tries to attain man using deceit. And if it still does not get man, then it uses even more deceptive claims and trickery. And if it still does not get man, then the prakriti finds new ways through anger by doing various types of obstinacy. And the hunger for man has been around for infinite time. The prakriti is definitely hungry for man. So what should we do? Well, this spiritual science is such that no one provokes, interferes, or finds faults. So gradually as the nyan gets nourished, then the prakriti will definitely come into normality. We simply want to hold on to these two levels. The first level of, is someone else getting hurt due to our karmic tumor of man? And the second level, does our karmic tumor of man give us suffering? When there is suffering, he will certainly see negatives of others or see them at fault. We wish to win over these two levels. Actually, instead of winning them over, we wish to maintain jagruti. I hurt others when I tried to receive man, or I hurt others when I got insulted. The fear of insult is the same as being hungry for man. The fear of insult is the same as begging or being hungry for man. If one is hungry for man, only then will he be fearful of insult. When he gets insulted, then he attacks the other person and binds vengeance or hurts them. And since he hurts them, it means the original disease is of man, because he hurt them due to man. He hurt them since he did not get man. So in our samyak today, we will analyze the part where we end up hurting others. We should first analyze a little in samyak that what is the form of our karmic tuber of man? What are its characteristics? How far has our man spread out? The man which we have, while doing seva in satsang, do we want special importance? Do we want to make an impression? Do we want man? What sort of inner intents or filled karmic stock do we have? We will analyze that and study it as the first step. Then secondly, we will do pratikaman for those we've hurt due to this man. Then the third part will be for the suffering that occurs if we do not get man, or do not get enough of it, or if someone else gets it, or if we are getting insulted. Then how should we apply the nyan at that point so that we can keep the jagruti of separation, see the nimitta as faultless, and dissolve the man with Dada's understanding of nyan? It's due to agnan that man is still around, and it will dissolve with nyan. As long as we do not have enough understanding to dissolve it, we will keep it separate and do penance until then. This suffering is because of man. The nimitta is not at fault. We need to do penance until then. You can try to do that. There is great material in Dada's 9th Aptavani regarding man. There is great content in Aptavani 1, 2, and 6 as well. There is also a chapter on ego at the end of Aptavani 10. And there is a beautiful series of nirumas of maybe 10, 12, or 15 parts, which are 2 hours each, in the Wales retreat, or the Chicago Guru Purnima, or Houston, or wherever it took place. In America, London, or Montreal, Niruma has done a lot of beautiful satsangs on man. So what is the main point? It's that we have this disease, and we will find its cure from Dada's Nyan. We will also study the matter discussed in our satsang today. We want to understand the original form of man. Then gradually we want to clear out the parts where we've hurt others due to our man. And then while remaining in the self and using nyan, we want to clear out and dissolve the sufferings which arose because of man. We need to make the purusharth a real spiritual effort to dissolve man with the right understanding by providing closure and by seeing the nimitta as faultless and finding a solution. We will recognize our prakriti today and see what kind of man we have in our prakriti. We need to keep a normal amount of man. We're not trying to cut it out too much. Have normal worldly interactions with everyone, help everyone, but the unnatural characteristics that arise of being really hungry for man, and if we don't get it, then a lot of suffering arises, or we end up hurting others. That is the part we want to touch. Not the normal man, but the unnatural man. Then what will happen is that we will clear this inner garbage until the man reaches a normal point, and then the normal man will get dissolved using nyan. It is such that it will only dissolve through Jnan. As we practice turning back, the normal man will also dissolve through Jnan. Normal man has arisen naturally and spontaneously, and it is in the form of a result. Whereas in the unnatural man, one's own hunger arises, and that disease of being hungry for man is such that it carries forward to the next life. That's where we wish to remain aware, because it's due to that unnatural man that we end up hurting others, or being hurt, or seeing others' negatives, and telling them to other people, or accusing others. The reason behind all that is the hunger for man. That is the fault we will all study today. We will specifically see this in Samaik. Understand the form of man which is in our Prakriti. And if you cannot see enough in Samaik today, or however much you can see, but you can certainly see the second part of it. Have we hurt anyone due to our man? Have we seen the nimit as the culprit, or at fault, or have we seen their negatives while hurting them, or being hurt ourselves? We will do a great amount of pratikraman for that case. So let's do Samaik. We've talked about a lot of things, so we'll study man, because this disease of man is definitely very big. If someone finds our faults, even to the slightest extent, by saying, move away, you've done this wrong, don't come here, stop doing that, hand it over to someone else. If we hear anything like that, then the entire boiler erupts. That's when we can realize how big our man has become. It's gotten to a point where we want others to do things according to our will. And we end up erupting if someone does things without asking us. So the man has extended this much. We will have to turn back from that. And if such a scenario arises where someone opposes us, then we should accept it and say, it's good that you warned me. I'll be careful and we will come together using teamwork and involve everyone. My disease increases if I do the work alone. So it's good that you involve me. It's beneficial for me. You are all helpful to me. We should take it positively like that. We should not protect our man. This is how we will practically cut our disease. Theoretically, we will see a lot of it in our samik today, and we will cut it off like that. By doing that, we eventually need to become free from this karmic tuber of man. We need to keep doing this purusharth until we become vitrag, or free from attachment and abhorrence. So let's do the vidhi. O Dada Bhagavan, O Lord Simandar Swami, with the pure applied awareness as the self, wherever the kashaya of man and the form of man has arisen in one's own prakriti, through the nimit of seva, through the nimit of others, through the nimit of workers, through the nimit of giving seva to others, or through the nimit of receiving seva, wherever the kashaya of man arises, may I study all those occasions and the prakriti of man. Give me the energy to see that in Samaik. If I've hurt anyone through this man, or if suffering has arisen within myself, and if I've seen the nimit at fault, or if I've painted the nimit in a negative light, in order to satisfy my own inner tendencies, or if I've increased my man by nourishing it, then give me the energy to see all those faults in Samaik. I surrender my mind, speech, and body, all illusions related to my name, charge karma, subtle discharge karma, and gross discharge karma, at the lotus feet of Dada Bhagavan. Do a nice samik by going deep within. Keep this as homework material, and in the future satsangs or programs, I mean that you can repeatedly do this samik more and more at your home. If some clashes have occurred, then this is an opportunity to understand our own man. We should do a great samik then and catch these faults and constantly remain aware. Because these enemies, it is only when we destroy these inner enemies that we can reach the state of an arihant. These are the enemies which we need to destroy. Our state of experience will increase based on how many of these enemies we clear out. Therefore, this Purusharth, we should note down today's Samayik, and we should repeatedly do this Purusharth of doing Samayik at home. Everyone should definitely do this Samayik today.